All right, today we have the Trouts who are going to give us an update on their lives. Man, I miss seeing you guys.
We miss you too.
Yeah,
you too.
Y'all heard that, huh? Amen. Listen, so give us an update. How are y'all doing?
Right now, we're doing really well.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm doing good.
Okay, why did you say right now?
Because it's been a little bit of difficulty transitioning from him going to work every day to being home.
Okay.
And just being separated from everybody, just totally being locked in.
Yeah, yeah. Dennis?
Yeah, I think Julie has a routine, so I'm at home working, but I take breaks, so I think I interfere with her sometimes.
Routine, yeah. Yeah, so. I understand that.
But yeah, I'm doing good. I mean, working from home, you know.
Yeah, yeah, I understand that. Maria and I, you know, we're there, and we had to learn to live together after 40 plus years.
It's like, I am not ready for you to retire, Julie.
Yeah, exactly.
And I'm ready to retire.
That's right. Yes, I told her that I was going to retire and manage her. She said, what are you going to do? I said, I'm going to manage you every day. You know, I'm not going to even tell y'all the answer I got for the response from that. But what are y'all doing?
Well, I was telling some close friends of mine that I think I'm the reason for the coronavirus because mm-hmm. in the beginning of the year, I just felt like I was flat spiritually. Mm. Wasn't reading the word, wasn't spending time with the Lord. And now it's like, because I was forced to be still, I want to come out different. I want to come out changed.
Yeah.
I don't want this to be for nothing spiritually.
Amen.
So yeah. I've been
Amen.
Journaling, that's, reading. You know.
Yeah. Wow, that's good. You know, the Bible says that that we should thank God for everything. So with coronavirus, amen, you're blessing us today because although we can't thank God for the virus, as you stated, we can thank God for the opportunity to see him work in our lives.
Right.
Amen, through that. So that's great.
Yeah.
Amen. Dennis?
Yeah, for me, I'm just, other than working, you know, I'm working from home. But yeah, I was just telling Julie the other day, for me, it's like, I'm enjoying the day, you know, a day at a time, because my typical bent is always looking what's going to happen next, what's going to happen next. And what God's telling me is that live in the moment, you know, because looking to see what's going to happen down in the future,
you're
the ones doing it, not being anxious and things
right.
like that.
Amen.
You know, so that's kind of what I've been doing. And other than that, getting back to some of my hobbies, like wood carving and stuff like that.
Amen, amen. Now, I know that both of you had corona.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Amen, and God delivered you and blessed you and brought you through.
Yes.
Amen, I'm so glad. I got so much work for y'all. Amen. But I want to know, too, and give us an update. What do y'all miss most about not gathering here with our community? Church.
To me, it's not just our community on Sundays, but it's also our small group on Thursday nights.
Yeah.
You know, it's thankful for technology and the ability to see each other through the screen, but it's just lacking.
Yeah.
I miss the contact with people and, you know, especially when each Sunday you see people that you don't see during the week.
Right.
And just to be able to catch up and if there's something you knew that you'd been praying with them for, to check in with them and just the physical ability to, you know, talk to them.
Yeah, and you know, Julie, that's one of the reasons we've decided that under the present health restrictions that not to open up. Because if we open up under the current guidelines, we wouldn't be able to even talk to each other here.
Right.
You'd have to come in, mask up, and go back out.
Well, and two, I was thinking I wouldn't want to be the one when I got to the door and you said, sorry, we already have 75 people or whatever, and be turned away.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
Yeah. But you know what? From my perspective, that would be kind of fun. Nope. Not you. Nope.
But then what just happens easy. If you let the next person in?
That's right. Amen. But so, yes, we missed that. Thank you for reminding us.
Yeah.
that we need a hug and a laugh and a conversation and to see other human beings and have some contact.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Amen. Dennis,
yeah,
what do you miss?
Same thing. I just miss seeing people, being around them. And, you know, Julie's probably thinking, what's he, because she thinks I don't like being around people, but I do. I mean, I'm more introvert than her.
Right.
But still, it's just being here, and this is family.
Yes.
Right? I mean, this is family, so you miss your family.
Yes.
And, you know, just being.
And the energy that is when you're
yeah, that's a lot of energy.
In the
United
service.
Worship.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, united worship.
Yeah.
See, I'm preaching again.
There you
Amen.
Go.
Y'all should, everybody should be worshiping already. But we come here and united.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there is a feeling and an experience. Yes. All right. Well, God bless y'all. Anything else y'all want to say as an update?
It's good just being here.
Amen.
You know.
Well, praise the Lord. And like you all, we're looking forward to that day when we can hug and fellowship with each other in a way that connects our hearts and our hands.
Yes.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
So God bless. Thank you all for coming today.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right.